Okay, so now let us discuss multiplicative identity and inverse. So first of all, let's actually get into multiplicative identity. Now, what exactly is multiplicative identity? Now, this is actually a number, a digit, with which if you multiply another number, say A, you get the same exact number. Now, there is only one number that can do that. Let us actually see. A multiplied by some number that you get the same exact number A again. Now what can be that number? There's only one number that can do that. One. One is the multiplicative identity, okay? So let us actually do a problem. We have four, right? We have four. Now multiply four with a number that you get four again. Now, yes, it is one. And one is the multiplicative identity, and that is it. Multiplicative inverse. Let's actually get into the multiplicative inverse part right now. Now, any number which is the opposite of the first one, both of them give the number one. That both of those numbers will be called multiplicative inverses of each other. If you have A, right? If you have A and you multiply that with B, at the end you get 1. Now, only actually there are a lot of numbers that can do that. Let us actually get into some of them. If we have 10 and you multiply that with 1 over 10, you get 1. So for this, we will say that 10 is the multiplicative inverse of 1 over 10, because when you actually multiply them, the both of them cancel out and at the end you get 1. That is all for multiplicative inverse. So let us actually do some problems before ending our lecture. Let us say we have a number 5 and we multiply that with some number to get 5 again. What would the answer be? 1. Let's say we have 10,000 and we want 10,000 back again. What are we going to multiply that with? 1. Now over to multiplicative inverse. What is the multiplicative inverse of, let's say this is the question, what is the multiplicative inverse of 10,000? The multiplicative inverse of 10,000 is what? Yes, 1 over 10,000, because when you multiply both of them you get 1.